Redmond, and I am representing Strike for Black Lives. You can look it up on strikeforblacklives.com. And part of the mission of Strike for Black Lives is to talk about police accountability. So, you know, I'm from the Deep South, even though I'm claiming dual citizenship. My dad is from East St. Louis, Illinois, but my home, thank you, represents Milwaukee, East my home community where I was raised was Meridian, Mississippi. And there was a time in Mississippi when Black people said, "Will you stop demeaning and brutalizing us when we go vote?" And what they received back from the majority white community was, "We can't stop. We have an ingrained culture. It's so hard for us." And then the federal government came in with consequences, and like tongues on the day of Pentecost, they could stop. It was amazing how that happened. When you mess with their money and their freedom, they could stop killing people when they went to vote. Now when I talk to you, none of you are afraid to vote, are you? Right. So my point is this, that I wanted to ask the community and law enforcement people. When a young man is given the death penalty in the streets and is unarmed and the policeman gets off, and we watch it on videotape and the policeman gets off, at what point will we begin to demand consequences in the form of their freedom and their federal funds being tied to their behavior? I would love to hear from you.
I want to shift gears to a second question. The rules of engagement, or you can answer any of my questions.